वेलकम टू एल के आर आर इन सीबीएसई इंग्लिश स्कूल। सो स्टूडेंट्स, एक्चुअली केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन, इन केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड कंसेप्ट। द नेम ऑफ कंसेप्ट इज द टाइप ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन। वी नो दैट दिस केमिकल रिएक्शन एक्चुअली हाउ मच टाइप इट इज, द फाइव टाइप्स वी नो दैट। One is the combination reaction, it is actually we already completed definition as well as example as well as activity of the combination reaction. Now second one concept or second one type of chemical reaction, it is called as the decomposition reaction. So actually in last class we defined definition of decomposition reaction and one activity it is again completed. Third one type, it is called as the displacement reaction, that we study. Double displacement reaction, fourth one type, that we will also study. And oxidation redox oxidation and reduction reaction, that we also will study. So in today's class our concept is actually the type of decomposition reaction. Actually in state board syllabus this decomposition, types of decomposition reaction is not given, but in our NCERT syllabus, which is in CBSE syllabus, again in ICSE pattern, that is the decomposition reaction, type of decomposition reaction is actually given, and it's actually also very important for NEET, JEE, MHT, CET. So this decomposition reaction, it is actually the classified into the three types. How much type of the decomposition reaction? Three types. One, it is called as the thermal decomposition reaction. Thermal decomposition reaction. Second one, type, it is the electrolytic decomposition reaction. Electrolytic, this decomposition reaction. And third one, it is actually photo decomposition reaction. Photo decomposition reaction. Means these are the three classification of the decomposition reaction: thermal, electrolytic, and photo decomposition reaction. So we will explain this decomposition reaction one by one. Out of this we'll explain that is the first one, that is the decomposition reaction, is the thermal decomposition reaction. So actually we know that when actually in decomposition reaction, from the single reactant to our more product, it is actually formed, it is decomposition reaction. And this thermal decomposition reaction, it is defined as a decomposition reaction. It is carried out in a heat. Means actually this decomposition reaction is take place due to heat. Word thermal, thermal means actually due to the temperature, due to the heat, the reaction is take place. It is the definition of the thermal decomposition reaction is defined as it is carried out in the heat, in the presence of heat. And that type of decomposition reaction is called as the thermal decomposition reaction. So we having the number of example like in last class, that is the one example we already studied, that is the name of the compound, it is the calcium carbonate CaCO3. When heat is given to this calcium carbonate, we know that is the calcium oxide is formed. And second one, that is the carbon dioxide gas is formed. So this reaction, if you observe, this reaction is take place in presence of heat, and from the single reactor two product is formed. That's why this type of the decomposition reaction is the thermal decomposition reaction. So we also having the second one example, student, like we already completed in last class one activity, hydrated ferrous sulfate. Means we know that FeSO4.7H2O, when it is heated, then we know that ferrous sulfate is formed. And this 7H2O liquid, it is actually 7H2O means liquid, it is actually separated this reaction. It is again carried out in a presence of what? That is the heat, in presence of temperature. That's why this is also the thermal decomposition reaction. Now, actually, we have to study one activity, that activity we have given in our syllabus. Aim of activity to study decomposition of a lead nitrate. To study decomposition of lead nitrate, it is actually our aim. Then second one term, that is the requirement, is also required, that is the apparatus. In requirement, we know that test tube is required, okay. Then, actually, in this reaction, heat is required, that's why burner, or you can use spirit lamp, okay. Then, chemical like the lead nitrate, we again use in this experiment. Then, we will use, that is the procedure for this reaction. In procedure, two points is very important. What is that point? Take 2 gram of this lead nitrate in the test tube. In this test tube, we will take, that is the 2 gram of lead nitrate. Why this same test tube? In the test tube on the spirit lamp or on the burner. After applying this procedure, we will get the observation. What we'll get the observation. So actually, this is the lead nitrate. Here, if you observe, that the color of this lead nitrate is the white in color. With the color of lead nitrate, it is the white in color. And after heating this lead nitrate, it is formed the three substances. Which substances form? Two or more components with three substances form. Check that white color, it is converted into the yellow color with the lead oxide is formed PbO. Again, in this reaction, nitrogen dioxide gas is also formed. Here, brown fumes, which color? That is the brown fumes is formed. And colorless oxygen gas, it is actually formed. These two gases actually evolved in this reaction. Means I will represent this reaction in the form of chemical reaction, chemical equation. P B N O 3 twice. It is the chemical formula of lead nitrate. Physical state is the solid. Color of this lead nitrate is the white in color. What is the color? White in color. Now, heat is given this lead nitrate. Because of heat is given, that's why we simply represent arrow. On the arrow, delta symbol is used. So, PbO is formed. And that PbO, it is the lead oxide. So, what is the PbO? What is the remaining? NO3 twice. What is remaining? NO3 twice is remaining. So, to balance the chemical reaction, we will take twice PbNO3. Twice. Now, we will simply balance the reaction. Twice PbO, twice Pb. And out of this, how much oxygen atom is with the 6 and this 12. Then, 2 oxygen atoms are attached. Then second one, nitrogen gas, NO2 gas is. So, actually, we simply take how much nitrogen, this 2 and this 2, it is actually 4 NO2. Means this oxygen is now 8. We'll check this balance or not after writing this chemical. What is remaining now? So, oxygen gas is remaining. How much? Here 2, here 8. Means only 2 oxygen gases. And this is the yellow color. It is brown fume. And the colorless. It is what? Colorless. So this type of chemical reaction is taking place. Why is the thermal decomposition reaction? Because this reaction carried out in presence of temperature. So our question is balance or not. That's must. Will identify will check. 2 Pb. How much oxygen atom? This 3 into 2, 6. It is again multiplied by 2 means 12. Here 2 oxygen. And after that, here 8 means actually 10. And this 2, 12. Well, oxygen atom is there, that's why oxygen is again balanced. Nitrogen 2 and this 2 actually 4. Means lead is balanced, oxygen is balanced as well as nitrogen is balanced. This is the balanced chemical reaction. And what is our conclusion? Conclusion is that this is a thermal decomposition. Which reaction? Thermal decomposition reaction, because it is carried out in presence of temperature, and from the single reactor it forms three products. One is the lead oxide yellow in color, nitrogen dioxide brown fume, and colorless gas. So thank you, students.